going. Morning bell ain't rung yet. Get back to sleep.
I want to beat the other fellas down to the street. I don't want anyone should see. I ain't been walking so good.
Quit griping. You know how many fellas fake a limp for sympathy? That bum leg of yours is a gold mine.
If someone gets the idea I can't make it on my own, then they'll lock me up in the refuge for good. Now be a pal, Jack, and help me down.
Whoa! You want to bust your other leg too?
No. I want to go down.
You'll be down there soon enough. Hey, take a moment. Drink in my penthouse. High above the stinking streets of New York.
You're crazy.
What, because I like a breath of fresh air? Because I like seeing the sky and the stars?
You're seeing stars, all right.
Them streets down there, they suck the life right out of my old man. Years of rotten jobs, stomped on by bosses, and when they finally broke him, they tossed him to the curb like yesterday's paper. Well, they ain't doing that to me.
But everyone wants to come here.
Yeah, New York's fine for folks that can afford a big, strong door to lock it out. But I tell you, Crutchy, there is a whole other way out there. So you keep your small life in a big city. Give me a big life in a small town. They say folks is dying to get here. Me, I'm dying to get away to this little town out west that's spanking new. And while I ain't never been there, I can see it clear as day. If you want, I bet you could see it too.
Who, me?
Yeah, you.
No.
Close your eyes. Come with me. Come on. Where it's clean and green and pretty. And they went and made a city out of clay. Why, the minute that you get there, folks will walk right up and say, welcome home, son. Welcome home to Santa Fe. Planting crops, splitting rails, swapping tails around the fire. Except for Sunday when you lie around all day. Soon your friends are more like family and they's begging you to stay. Ain't that neat? Living sweet in Santa Fe.
Well, you got folks there?
Yeah, ain't got no folks, nowhere. You?
I don't need folks. I got friends.
Hey, how's about you come with me? Yeah, no one worries about no gimp leg in Santa Fe. You just hop a palomino. You ride in style.
Feature me riding in style.
Oh, I bet a few months of clean air and you could toss that crutch for good.
Santa Fe, you can bet we won't let them bastards beat us. We won't beg no one to treat us fair and square. There's a life that's worth the living, and I'm gonna do my share. Work the land, taste the sun, swim the whole Rio Grande just for fun. Watch me stand, watch me run.
Hey, don't you know that we's a family? Would I let you down? No way. Just hold on, kid, till that train makes Santa Fe. Time for dreaming's done. Hey, Specs, Racer, Henry, Albert, Elmer, get a move on, boys. Them papers don't sell themselves.
Hey, Albert, Elmer, Specs, you heard Jack. Get a move on.
Who's had the most beautiful dream? My lips are still tingling.
Ooh, a pretty girl.
Like a lamb.
Hey, that's my cigar.
Steal another.
Hey, look, it's bath time at the zoo. I thought that I'd surprise my mother.
If you could find her.
Who asked you?
Hey, tapes ain't something like they used to. I need a new sound spot. Got any ideas?
From Bottle Alley to the harbor, there's easy pickings guaranteed.
Try any bank or bum or barber, they almost all knows how to read.
It's a crooked game we're playing, one we'll never lose. Long as suckers don't mind paying just to get bad news.
Ain't it a fine life? Harry is a better to it all.
Oh, step back, Romeo. Nothing what concerns you here. Morning, miss. Can I interest you in the latest news?
The paper isn't even out yet.
Oh, I'd be delighted to bring it to you personally.
I've got a headline for you. Cheeky boy gets nothing for his trouble.
Back to the bench, slugger. You struck out.
Oh, I'm crushed.
Hey, Crutchy, what's your leg say? Gonna rain?
No rain, but partly cloudy, clear by evening.
They ought to bottle this guy, huh?
And the limp sells 50 papes a week all by itself.
I don't need the limp to sell papes. I got poisonality. It takes a smile that spreads like butter.
The kind that turns a lady's head.
It takes an orphan with a daughter.
Who's also blind
and mute and dead.
Stars, snakes, and winters. Start out sweating, end up sneezing, in between it falls.
Well, it's a fine life, Gary in the middle.
Well, it's a fine life, Gary in the middle.
Bunch of big shots, tossing out of field.
Big shots, crossing out of
field. Hey, what's the hold up? Waiting makes me antsy. I like living chancy.
Harlem to the Lancy, what a fine life.
But it's bound to rain sooner or later.
So give me half a cup of
something to wake me up.
I gotta find it.
I'll say anything I am the.
Cause that two for a penny. If I take too many pieces, it'll just make me feel after.
Got a feeling that I had my eyes on the headline.
Ain't got a like me,
we'll give it all.
When I bet you didn't all that
crazy. It's my back and know a better.
How to make a new these
days. I wanna move the next edition.
Give us it that way.
How about a crooked politician?
Can't get with that, ain't news no more.
Down to Grand Central Station, down to City Hall. We can fix our circulation, walk until we fall.
All we have here, carry in the band of it's a band.
We're always out there, now looking at the sun and out.
Clear picture.
The trolley strike? Not again.
It's 3 weeks of the same story.
They're killing us with that snoozer.
Hey, make way, step aside.
Oh, dear me. What is that unpleasant aroma? I hear the sewers may have backed up during the night.
Or it could be
the Delancey brothers.
Say, Oscar, word on the street says you and your brother are taking money to beat up striking trolley workers.
So? It's honest work.
But cracking the heads of defenseless workers?
I take care of the guy who takes care of me.
Hey, ain't your father one of the strikers?
Guess he didn't take care of me!
Hey, you want some of that too, you lousy
prick? Whoa! That's not nice, Morris.
He's 5-1, Zax. Kong's there,
man. Come on.
Get back in.
How'd you like us picking on you, huh? Maybe we should find out. Come on, wait till I get my hands on you! Gotta catch him first!
Weasel.
Ain't that what I said? I'll take the usual.
100 papes for the wise guy.
Hey, how is it going, Weasel?
Hey, at least call me mister.
Hey, I'll call you sweetheart if you'd spot me 50 papes.
Drop the cash and move along.
Whatever happened to Roman?
50 for the race. Next!
Good morning, Mr. Weasel.
Hey, 50 papes for Crutchy. Hey, look at this. A new kid.
I'm new too.
I'll take 20 newspapers, please.
Oh, 20 for the new kid. Let's see the dime.
I'll pay you when I sell them.
Funny kid. Come on, cash up front.
But whatever I don't sell, you buy back, right?
Oh, sure. And whenever you lose a tooth, I stick a penny under your pillow. This kid's a riot. Come on, cough up the cash or blow. All right. Come on, move it along. Albert, let me see your money.
You have a very interesting face. Right. You should try getting into the moving pictures.
You think I could?
Sure, buy a ticket. They let anyone in.
Hey, get out of here.
Excuse me, I paid for 20, but you gave me 19.
And you see how nice I was to this new kid? And what do I get for my civility? Ungrounded accusations.
He said beat it.
Oh, new kid's right, Weasel. You gave him 19. Hey, I'm sure it was an honest mistake. On account of Oscar can't count to 20 with his shoes on.
All right, here, come on, beat it.
Hey, give him another 50 papes.
I don't want more papes.
I'll take those papes. Jack, be on papes.
What kind of a newsie don't want more papes?
I don't know a charity case. I don't even know you.
His name's Jack.
This year's the famous Jack Kelly. He once escaped prison on the back of Teddy Roosevelt's carriage and made all the papes.
How old are you, kid?
I'm 10. Almost.
All right, if anybody asks, you're 7. Younger sells more papes, and if we're gonna be partners, you're gonna.
You want a partner?
Oh, selling with Jack's the chance of a lifetime. You learn from him, you learn from the best.
Well, if he's the best, then what's he want with me?
Cause you got a little brother, and I don't. That push could easily sell 1,000 papes a week. Hey, look sad, kid. We're gonna make millions.
This is my brother, David. I'm Les.
Nice to meet you, Davey. Look, my two bits come off the top, and then we split everything 70-30.
50-50! You win a triumph all fast when I'm a little kid.
60-40. That's my final offer.
Deal.
That's disgusting.
That's just business. Newsies, hit the streets! The sun is up, the headline stinks, and this kid ain't getting any younger.
We're always out there. He's a headline, he's on a mission. Kill the competition, now the next edition. We'll be out there, carrying the banner. Yes, out there, carrying the banner. Always out there, carrying the banner.
Go! Gentlemen! The world is in trouble. Our circulation is down for the third quarter in a row.
But Mr. Pulitzer, every paper's circulation is down since the war ended.
Whoever said war is hell was not trying to sell newspapers.
We could use an exciting headline.
Well, what have we got today?
The trolley strike.
But that's not exciting, it's epic!
It's boring. Folks want to know, is the trolley coming or am I walking instead? No one cares why.
And that strike's about to be settled. Governor Roosevelt just put his support behind the workers.
That man is a socialist.
Teddy Roosevelt is no socialist, he's an American hero!
The man wants to outlaw football for being too violent. Football? Violent? You're right, he's no socialist. He's a commie!
Mr. Pulitzer, please sit still.
Gentlemen, you're making Nunzio nervous. And when Nunzio gets nervous, I don't look pretty.
You never liked Roosevelt. You wrote an editorial against him day after day when he ran for governor. And guess what? He got elected.
How can I influence voters when they're reading my opinion?
Big photos attract readers.
Do you know what big photos cost?
Both are flashy photos or headlines. How are we supposed to sell more papers?
There's an answer right before your eyes. You're just not thinking this through. People! Nunzio knows when he's cutting my hair. Trim a bit here, and then trim a bit there. It's the modest adjustment that fattens the bottom line.
And Mr. Pulitzer, please.
Shaving is tricky, the razor should float. Shave me too close, and you may cut my throat. It's the simplest solutions that bolster the bottom line.
And that helps us sell more papers? Well,
we don't sell papers, silly. Newsies sell papers.
Yeah, silly. Newsies sell papers.
I've got it. Right now we charge the newsies 50 cents per hundred paper.
Yes.
But if we raise the price to 60 cents per hundred...
Now you're getting somewhere.
A mere tenth of a penny per paper.
Every single newsie would have to sell 25 more papers just to make the same amount as always.
My thoughts exactly. It's genius.
It's going to be awfully rough on those children.
Nonsense! They'll be getting a real life lesson in economics. I couldn't give them a better education if they were my own. Give me a week and I'll train them to be like an army that's marching to war. Proud of themselves and so grateful to me, they'll be begging to pay even more. When there's dirt on our shoes, boys, for God's sakes, relax. Why throw them out? All you need is some wax. Listen well to these barbershop lessons, or they'll see you through.
When you're stuck in the muck, you'll be fine. You'll erase any trace of decline.
With a trim
and a slip
and a shine
and the power of the press, yes, once again it's fine. The price for the newsies goes up in the morning. Just a few common sense, gents. That's the bottom line.
Sing them to sleep, why don't you? Here. Extra, extra, terrified flight from Burning Inferno. You heard the story right here. Oh, thanks, mister.
You just made that up.
Did not. I said he heard it right here, and he did.
My father taught us not to lie.
Yeah, and mine taught me not to starve.
Hey, just sold my last paper.
I got one more.
Sell it or pay for it.
Give it here. Buy a paper from a poor orphan boy? Oh, you poor thing. Of course I'll take a newspaper. Here's a dime.
Born to the breed.
This is so much better than school.
Hey, don't even think it. Well, Pop goes back to work. We go back to school.
Hey, so how's about we divvy up the money, grab some chow, then we'll find you somewhere safe to spend the night.
We gotta get home. My folks will be waiting dinner.
Oh, you got folks?
Doesn't everyone?
Our dad tangled with a delivery truck on the job. Messed up his leg bad, so that's how come we had to find work.
Yeah, sure. That makes sense. Too bad about your dad.
Well, why don't you come home with us for dinner? Folks will be happy to have you.
Mom's a great cook.
Thanks for the invite, but I just remembered I got plans with a fella. He's probably waiting on me right now, so...
Is that the guy you're meeting?
Kelly! Run for it! Come on! All right, slow down. We lost him.
Hey, someone want to tell me why I'm running? I got no one chasing me. Who was that guy?
That was Snyder, the spider. A real sweetie. He runs a jail for underage kids called the Refuge. The more kids he locks up, the more the city pays him. Problem is, all that money goes right into his own pocket. Look, do yourselves a favor. Stay clear of him and the Refuge.
Hey, you up there, Shoe! No kids allowed in the theater.
Not even me, Miss Meta.
Jack Kelly. Oh, man of mystery. Well, get yourself down here and give me a hug. Where have you been keeping yourself, kid?
Never far from you, Miss Meta. Hey, boys, may I introduce Miss Meta Larkin, greatest star on the Bowery today. She also owns the joint.
The only thing I own is the mortgage. Pleasure, gents.
A pleasure. What's wrong with you?
Are you blind? She got no clothes on.
That's her costume.
But I can see her legs.
Well, just step aside and let him get a better look. Theater is not only entertaining, it's educational. Got the picture, kid?
Yeah, Miss Meta. I got a little situation out in the streets. Mind if I hide down here a while?
Oh, well, where better to escape trouble than a theater? Let me guess, Snyder's after you again.
Hey, Jack. Did you really escape jail in the back of Teddy Roosevelt's carriage?
What would the governor be doing at a juvenile jail?
Yeah, so happens he was running for office and wanted to show he cared about orphans and such. So, while he got his mug in the paper, I got my butt in the back seat, and off we rode together.
You really know the governor.
Oh, he don't, but I do. Say, Jack, when you've got some time, I'd like you to paint me some more of these backdrops. That last one you did was a doozy. Folks loved it. And things are going so well that I can actually pay.
Oh, Miss Med, I could not take your money.
You pictured that?
Oh, your friend is quite an artist.
Don't get carried away. It's a bunch of trees.
You're really good.
The boy's got natural aptitude.
Jeez, I never knew anyone with an aptitude.
Miss Meta! You're on!
I am? Well, how am I doing? Boys, lock the doors and stay all night. You're with Meta now.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the star of our show, Miss Meta Larkin!
I'm doing all right for myself, folks. I'm healthy, I'm wealthy, I'm wise. My investments and such have all gone up so much, seems whatever I touch starts to rise. I've got men, I've got money, and yet the thing I want most, I can't get. Oh, I like that. A mansion on Long Island Sound. I pulled up a weed, they found oil in the ground. But you telling me you don't want me around. Now, honey, that's rich. Some guys give me ermine, chinchilla, and mink. And some give me diamonds as big as a sink. But you wouldn't give me so much as a wink. Now, baby, that's rich. I get brandy from Andy and candy from Scott. Oh, and Frank and Eduardo chipped in for a yacht. I get stares from the fellas and prayers from the Pope. But I ran out my luck getting stuck on some dope.
Oh, honey, I was just talking about you. Now listen, sport, this life's too short to waste it on you. It may be rough, but soon enough, I'll learn to make do.
I should lock the door? Twice in one day. You think it's fate?
Please go away. I'm working.
A working girl, huh? Doing what?
Reviewing the show for the New York Sun.
Oh, I work for the World.
Somewhere out there, someone cares. Go tell them.
The view's better here.
Please go. I'm not in the habit of speaking to strangers.
Then you're gonna make a lousy reporter. Hey, the name's Jack Kelly.
Is that what it says on your rap sheet?
A smart girl, huh? I admire smart girls. Beautiful, smart, independent.
Do you mind? You got in for free. At least pay attention.
Sorry, Meta. I got no use for moonlight or sappy poetry. Love at first sight's for suckers, at least it used to be. Look, girls are nice, once or twice, till I find someone new. But I never planned on no one like you.
So come a-knocking on my door, you aren't welcome here no more. I should have known you stung like yesterday's trash. The night you stole my heart was $40 in cash. Turns out my bow is just
at first sight's for suckers. At least it used to be.
I feel bad for your wife. I won't be shaking.
What are you doing?
Quiet down. There's a show going on.
You are the most impossible boy ever.
No. I never planned on no one like you.
Fire sirens keep me awake all night.
Sirens are like lullabies to me. The louder they will, the better the headline. The better the headline, the better I eat. And better I eat.
And the farther away from you, I sleep.
Good morning, everybody. I'm sorry we're late. We had to help our mom with something.
The guy and mother? I was gonna get me one.
What did you do with the one you had?
He traded her for a box of cigars.
Hey, there was Coronas.
We have a father, too.
A mother and a father.
Oh, ain't we the hoi polloi?
So, how's it going today?
Ask me after they put up the headline.
Here it comes now!
New newsy price. 60 cents per 100.
What'd you say?
Is that news?
It is to me. They raised up the price of papes. 10 cents more 100. I can eat 2 days on a dime.
I'll be sleeping on the streets.
You already sleep on the streets.
In a waste neighborhood.
Oh, what's everyone standing around for? Come
Look,
on.
Get a load of this, Jack.
Like, pull it till it don't make enough already.
Tape for the newsies.
Relax, it's gotta be a gag.
Line up!
Good joke, Weasel. Really got the fellas going. I'll take 100 and be on my way.
100'll cost you 60.
I ain't paying no 60.
Then make way for someone who will.
You bet. Hey, me and the fellas will take a hike over to the joint.
Yeah. I'll save you the walk. They up their prices, too.
Then we'll take our business to the sun. Come on.
It's the same all around town. New day, new price.
Why the jack-up?
Oh, for them kind of answers, you gotta go a little further up the food chain. So you boys buying, or you moving on?
Come here, fellas.
They can't just do that, can they?
Hey, why not? It's their paper.
It's their world.
Hey, we got no rights.
Well, we got the right to starve. Come on, let's get our paper.
At 10 prices?
We got a choice.
Nobody's paying.
Stop grabbing it!
Come on.
Let the man work it out. Hey, Jackie, I'm thinking.
Yes, sure he is. Can she smell smoke?
Okay, come here. Look, here's the deal. If we don't sell papes, no one sells papes. Okay, no one gets to that window till they put the prices back where they belong.
You mean like a strike?
Yeah, you heard Davey, we're on strike.
Shut down this place like
them workers, shut down the trolleys.
And then the cops bust our heads, have them strikers are laid out with broke bones.
Cops ain't gonna care about a bunch of kids, right, Davey?
Leave me out of this, I'm just here trying to feed my family.
And the rest of us is on playtime? Look, just because we only make pennies, don't give nobody the right to rub our noses in it.
It doesn't matter. You can't strike, you're not a union.
Well, what if I says we is?
Well, there's a lot of stuff you gotta have in order to be a union. Like membership.
What do you call these guys?
And officers.
Well, I vote Jack president.
President Jack!
Well, how about a statement of purpose?
Must have left it in my other pants.
Hey, what's the statement of purpose? A reason for forming the union.
Well, what reason did the trolley workers have?
I don't know. Wages, work hours, safety on the job.
Well, who don't need that? Hey, I bet if your father had a union, you wouldn't be out here selling papes right now, yeah?
Yeah.
So, our union is hereby formed to watch each other's backs. Yeah, unioned we stand. Somebody write that down.
I got a pencil.
Oh, well, meet our Secretary of State.
All right.
What next?
If you want to strike, the membership's got to vote.
All right, so let's vote. What do you say, fellas? The choice is yours. Do we roll over and let Pulitzer pick our pockets, or do we strike?
Strike!
Yeah. You heard the voice of the membership. The Newsies of Lower Manhattan are now officially on strike.
Yeah!
All right.
Now,
well, wouldn't a strike be more effective if someone in charge knew about it?
Oh, good idea.
It'd be a pleasure to tell Weasel myself.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, nah, and who tells Pulitzer? Davey?
I don't know. I guess you do, Mr. President.
We do. What do we tell them?
The newspaper owners need to respect your rights as employees.
Yeah, Pulitzer and Hearst need to respect the rights of the working kids of this city.
You can't just change the rules when they feel like it.
Yeah, we do the work, so we get a say.
We got a union.
Hey, Pulitzer and Hearst, they think we're nothing. Are we nothing?
No! They need to understand that we are not enslaved to them. We are free agents.
Pulitzer and Hearst, they think they got us. Do they got us?
No!
We're a union now. The Newsboys Union, and we mean business.
Even though we ain't got hats or badges, we're a union just by saying so. And the world will know.
What's to stop some other kids from coming along to sell our papes?
Just let them try.
Yeah. Don't let them try.
Oh, yeah.
We're all in this together.
What's it gonna take to stop the wagons? Are we ready?
Yeah!
What's it gonna take to stop the scabbers? Can we do it?
Yeah!
We'll do what we gotta do until we break the will of mighty villain Joe. And the world will know! And eternal too!
Mr.
Pulitzer Hertz and Pulitzer, have we got news for you?
Did the world don't know,
but they're gonna pay. Set of Hawking headlines, we'll be making them today. And our ranks will grow,
and we'll kick their ears.
Yeah! And the world will know that we've been here.
Follow me, fellas.
When the circulation bell starts ringing, will we hear it?
No!
What if the Delanceys come out?
Will we hear it?
No! When you got 100 voices singing, who can hear a lousy whistle blow? And the world will know that this ain't no game. Cause we got a ton of rotting fruit and birthday cake. So they gave their word, well it ain't worth being. Now they gotta see what stop the presses really mean. And the old will leap and go back to sleep. And we got no choice but to see it through.
And we found our point, I lost my shoe.
And the world will. Yeah!
Pulitzer may own the world, but he don't own us.
Pulitzer may own the world, but he don't own us.
Crack the whip, but he won't whip.
Pulitzer may crack the whip, but he won't whip us. And the world will know we may keep it score. Even they gives us a break so we can stand more. We've been down too long, and we paid our dues.
And the things we do will be tomorrow's news.
And the die is cast, and the torch is passed,
and the war will rise,
and the streets will flow, and so the world will feel the fire and find me. No!
And stay up!
Whoa. You can tell Pulitzer a few days into this strike, he's gonna be begging for an appointment to see me! You got that? He got it.
Oh my god!
Yeah! Pulitzer may own the world, but he don't own us!
But he don't own us!
Pulitzer may crack the whip, but he won't whip us!
He won't whip us!
Kick us out.
Take away our vote.
Will we let him suck his crock of garbage down our throat? No! And the day we wait is the day we lose.
And this ain't for fun.
And it ain't for show.
Fight him so.
And so the world will feel the fire and finally no.
A glass of water for you, and one for you, and you, and... Oh! Who's the big spender? What ordered their seltzer?
Over here.
That will be 2 cents.
2 cents for a glass of seltzer? Just give me water.
How did I ever see that one coming?
I say we launch our strike in a most auspicious manner.
I don't know about that, but we sure did scare the bejeebies out of Weasel.
Yeah, we did.
See the Delanceys? They didn't know which way was up.
All right, so what's next?
Well, now you have to spread the word. Let the rest of the city's newsies know about the strike.
Okay, yeah, you heard Davey. Let's split up and spread the word.
I'll take Harlem.
I got Midtown.
I got the Bronx.
I got the Bowery.
All right, Tommy Boy, you got the East Side. Specs, Queens, and who wants Brooklyn? Oh, come on. Brooklyn, Spot Collins, Tyfe. Hey, Finch, you telling me you're scared of Brooklyn?
No, I ain't scared of no Tyfe. But that Spot Collins gets me a little jittery.
All right, me and Davey will take Brooklyn.
Me? No, I have to go.
Why is everyone so scared of Brooklyn?
What are you doing here?
Asking a question. Have you got an answer?
She says.
Brooklyn is the 6th largest city in the world.
What?
If you got Brooklyn, you hit the motherlode.
You know, for someone who works for the New York Sun, you sure spend an awful lot of time hanging around the world. So what's that about, huh? You following me?
The only thing I'm following is a story. A ragtag gang of ragamuffins wants to take on the kingmakers of New York. Think you have a chance?
Shouldn't you be at the ballet?
Question too difficult? I'll rephrase. Will the richest and most powerful men in New York give the time of day to a gang of kids who haven't got a nickel to their name?
You don't gotta be so insulting. I have a nickel.
So I guess you'd say you're a bunch of Davids looking to take on Goliath.
We never said that.
You didn't have to. I did.
You know, I seen a lot of papes in my time. I ain't never noted no girl reporters writing any hard news.
Wake up to the new century. The game is changing. How about an exclusive interview?
Ain't your beat entertainment?
This is entertaining so far.
Yeah, what's the last news story you wrote?
What's the last strike you organized?
Whoa. You're out of your league, Kelly. Yeah. Me thinks the lady needs to be handled by a real gentleman.
You think's wrong, Romeo.
How did she know my name?
I say we save any exclusive for a real reporter.
You see anybody else giving you the time of day? All right, so I'm just busting out of the social pages, but you give me the exclusive. Let me run with the story, and I promise I'll get you the space.
You really think we could be in the papes?
Shut down a paper like The World, and you'll make the front page.
All right, you want a story? Okay, be in front of the circulation gate tomorrow morning. You'll get one. Liam, bring your camera. You're going to want to snap a picture.
Yeah, front page the papes!
All right, boys, get out! I've got to set up this place for dinner. I've got paying customers what need tables.
Come on, we got newsies to visit.
Hey, you won't be shooing yourself when we get some mugs in the papes.
And the world first built, and the key is sure.
Are you selling newspapers to work your way through art school?
Art school? You kidding me?
But you're an artist. You've got real talent. You should be inside the paper illustrating, not outside hawking it.
Maybe that ain't what I want.
So tell me what you want.
Can't you see it in my eyes?
Ooh, Jack!
Have you always been their leader?
I'm a blowhard. Davey's the brains.
Modesty is not a quality I would have pinned on you.
You got a name?
Catherine Plummer.
What's the matter, ain't you sure?
It's my byline, the name I publish under. So tell me about tomorrow. What are you hoping for?
I'd rather tell you what I'm hoping for tonight.
Mr. Kelly.
Today we stopped our newsies from carrying out the papes. But the wagons still delivered to the rest of the city. Tomorrow, we stopped the wagons.
Are you scared?
Do I look scared? But, ask me again in the morning.
Good answer. Good night, Mr. Kelly.
Oh, come on, where you running? It ain't even supper time yet.
I'll see you in the morning. And off the record, good luck.
Hey, Plummer. Write it good. We both got a lot riding on you.
You heard the man. Write it good. Write it good, or it's back to wheezing your way through the flower show. No pressure. Let's go. Newsies, stop the world. A little hyperbole never hurt anyone. With all eyes fixed on the trolley strike, there is another battle brewing in the city. And if I could just write about it. Come on, Catherine, those boys are counting on you.
write what you know, so they say. All I know is I don't know what to write or the right way to write it. This is big, lady, don't screw it up. This is not some little vaudeville I'm reviewing. Poor little kids versus rich, greedy sourpusses. Huh, it's a cinch, it could practically write itself. And let's pray it does, because as I may have mentioned, I have no clue what I'm doing. Am I insane? This is what I've been waiting for. Well, that plus the screaming of 10 angry editors. A girl? It's a girl! How the hell is that even legal? Look, just go and get her. Not only that, there's a story behind a story. Thousands of children exploited, invisible. Speak up, take a stand, and there's someone to write about it. That's how things get better. Give those little guys some ink, and when it dries, just watch what happens. Those kids will live and breathe right on the page, and once they're center stage, you watch what happens. And who's there with her camera and her pen? As boys turn into men, they'll storm the gates, and then just watch what happens when they do. A modern-day David is poised to take on the rich and powerful Goliath. With the swagger of one twice his age, armed with nothing more than a few nuggets of truth, Jack Kelly stands ready to face the behemoth Pulitzer. Now that's how you turn a boy into a legend. Picture a handsome, heroically charismatic, plain-spoken, know-nothing, skirt-chasing, cocky little son of a. Lie down with dogs and you wake up with a raise and a promotion. So he's a flirt, a complete egomaniac. The fact is he's also the face of the strike. What a face, face the fact. That's a face that could save us all from sinking in the ocean. Like someone said, power tends to corrupt, and absolute power, wait, corrupts. Absolutely, that is genius! But give me some time and I'll be twice as good as that 6 months from never. Just look around at the world we're inheriting and think of the one we'll create. Their mistake is they got old. That is not a mistake we'll be making. No, sir, we'll stay young forever. Give those kids and me the brand new century and watch what happens. It's David and Goliath, do or die. The fight is on. And I can't watch what happens. But all I know is nothing happens if you just give in. It can't be any worse than how it's been. And it just so happens that we just might win. So whatever happens, let's begin.
Is anybody else coming?
I got no clue.
Hey, you seen Spud Cullen, right? What did he say?
Yeah, sure, we seen him.
Him and about 20 of his gang.
And them Brooklyn boys is big.
Hey, and I gotta say, Spot was very impressed, wasn't he?
I'd say. So, they're with us?
Well, that all depends on how you look at it. If you look and see Brooklyn, then they're with us.
They wanted proof we're not gonna fold at the first sign of trouble.
Are we?
We are not. Look, there's us and Harlem.
Not so fast, boss. Harlem wants to know what Brooklyn's gonna do.
Okay, how about Queens?
Well, Queens will be right here backing us up.
Yeah, see?
Just as soon as they get the nod from Brooklyn.
Yeah, I got the same fisheye in Midtown.
Say, Oscar, it looks like we got some bum information about a strike happening here today. Not that I'm complaining. My skull-busting arm could use a day of rest.
Are we doing the right thing?
Sure we are. Hey, maybe we should put this off a couple days.
No, we can't! Wait, Jack, say something! Tell them if we back off now, they'll never listen to us again!
Listen, fellas, we cannot back down now. No matter who does or doesn't show, like it or not, this is when we take a stand.
How's about we just don't show for work? They'll send a message.
No, please, they'll just replace us. Look, they need to see us stand our ground. Come on, Davey, tell him.
Now is the time to seize the day. Stare down the odds and seize the day. Minute by minute, that's how you win it. We will find a way. But let us seize the day.
Hey, Jack, look what I made. Cool, huh? Strike! That's great.
That's pitiful.
Don't be so quick to judge. Maybe Pulitzer will see that out his window and feel sorry for us.
Hey, Specs, any sign of reinforcements? Davey?
Courage cannot erase our fear. Courage is when we face our fear. Tell those with power, safe in their tower, we will not obey. Behold the brave battalion that stands side by side. Too few in numbers and too proud to hide. Then say to the others who did not follow through, you're still our brothers and we will fight for you. Now is the time to seize the day. Stare down the odds and seize the day. Once we've begun, if we stand as one, someday become somehow. And the prayer becomes a vow. And the struggle.
The sun is up, the birds are singing. It's a beautiful day to crack some heads, don't you think? Step right up and get your papes.
Are you working or trespassing, huh? What's your pleasure?
Who are they? Scabs, who do you think?
They just come in here and take our jobs, huh?
Hey, back up, wait a minute. We all stand together or we don't have a chance. Jack!
No, I know, I hear you. Listen, fellas. I know somebody put yous up to this. Probably paid you. Little extra money too, yeah? Yeah, well, it ain't right, okay? Pulitzer thinks we're rats with no respect for nothing, including each other. Is that who we are? Yeah, well, we stab each other in the back, and yeah, that's who we are. But if we stand together, we changed the whole game. And it ain't just about us, okay? No, all around this city, there are boys and girls who ought to be out playing or going to school. Instead, they're slaving to support themselves and their folks. Ain't no crime to being poor. No, not one of us complains if the work we do is hard. All we ask is a square deal. Fellas, I beg you, for the sake of all the kids in every sweatshop, factory, and slaughterhouse in this town, throw down your papes and join the strike.
Please.
I'm with you.
Answer the call and don't delay.
Answer the call and don't delay. Folks, we'll be riding. If we're united, let us seize the day.
Getting right at the end of the day, who are you gonna trust?
Them or them?
Yeah! Now that I'm hearing it loud and clear.
Now that I'm hearing it loud and clear.
Like it or not, we're drawing near.
Like it or not, we're drawing near. Judgment Day is here.
What the hell? Me Me father's gonna kill me anyway.
House into Harlem. Look what's begun.
enough, they're slaughtering us!
Off to the refuge with you, little man.
Murphy!
Tilly!
Folks, we finally got a headline. Lucy's crushed as bulls attack. Crutchy's calling me dumb, Crip's just too damn slow. Guys are fighting, bleeding, falling. It's the good old Captain Jack. Captain Jack just wants to close his eyes and go! Let me go. Far away, somewhere they won't ever find me, and tomorrow won't remind me of today. When the city's finally sleeping, and the moon looks old and gray, I get on a train that's bound for Santa Fe. And I'm gone, and I'm done. No more running, no more lying, no more fat old man denying me my pay. Just a moon so big and yellow, it turns night right into day. Dreams come true, yeah they do, in Santa Fe. Where does it say you gotta live and die here? Where does it say a guy can't catch a break? Why should you only take what you're given? Why should you spend your whole life living trapped where there ain't no future? Even at 17, breaking your back for someone else's sake. If the life don't seem to suit ya, then how about a change of scene? Far from the lousy headlines and the deadlines in between. Santa Fe, my old friend, I can't spend my whole life dreaming, though I know that's all I seem inclined to do. I ain't getting any younger, and I wanna start brand new. I need space and fresh air, let them laugh in my face, I don't care, save my. I'll be there. Just be real, is all I'm asking. Not some painting in my head. Cause I'm dead if I can't count on you today. I got nothing if I ain't got Santa Fe.
Thank you.
water's all around, and I'll never say I didn't do nothing for you. And before you say that water is nothing, just ask a fish in the desert.
Why do old people talk?
Hey, to prove they're still alive.
Good morning, gentlemen!
Quiet down.
Would you get a load of these glom mugs? Could these really be the same boys who made front page of the New York Sun?
Oh, wait, what?
Let me see that. Come on. Let me look at it.
Whisby!
You got us in the paper.
You got yourselves in the paper.
Newsy stopped the world. Now that's a headline even Albert could sell.
What else do you got?
Mine's the only story that ran. Pulitzer has declared a blackout on all strike news, so even I'm shut down now. I heard they arrested Crutchy. Did they get Jack too?
That the Lancey brothers were telling a story that they took it on the lam, the first set of cops.
Jack, don't run from no fight!
Take it down, shortstop. I'm just reporting the news.
Hey, for jumping Jack's sake, can you stow to seriously long enough to just drink in the moment? I'm famous!
What of it?
I used to be what? When you're famous, the world is your oyster.
What?
What?
Your what?
What is it?
Your oyster. Your oyster.
Again, can I help it? Oyster.
You know, you fancy clam with the pearl inside.
Oh, your oyster!
Hey, that's what I said, your oyster.
Oh, yeah, okay. Yeah, well, how much does being famous pay?
You don't need money when you're famous. They give you whatever you want. Gratis!
Such as?
A pair of new shoes with matching laces.
Permanent box that you said racist.
I'm strummy on a ride with a sour pickle. Personal puss on a wooden nickel.
Look at me, I'm the king of New York. Suddenly, I'm respectable, staring right at you, lousy with Thatcher.
Nothing with all my muckety mucks, I'm pulling my dough and going deluxe.
And there I be, and I'm pretty, it's my city, I'm the king of New York.
Watch with the chin a twirling.
A baby old man in an indoor toilet.
I'll try to
hang regular beat for a star reporter. M-Tray Punk, she's the king of New York.
I'm the king of New York.
We were sunk. Pale and pitiful,
Buncho and Noodles,
Poses, Poodles,
almost about to drown in the drink,
and drown the thin ink.
So what's that from?
Yeah!
I have liquor, flavor,
sneaker, when you're eating. I gotta be either dead or dreaming. Just look at that cake with my face beaming. Tomorrow they may wrap dishes in, but I was a star for one whole minute.
Come on.
Oh.
Dear Jack, greetings from the refuge. How are you? I'm okay. Guess I wasn't much help yesterday. You just talked to me real good with my crutch. Oh yeah, Jack. This is Crutchy, by the way. Is he a guards? They rude. They say, jump, kid, you jump or you're screwed. But the food ain't so badly so far. The Sufan ain't brung us no food. Ha, ha. I miss the rooftops. Sleeping right out in the open, in your penthouse in the sky. There's a cool breeze blowing even in July. Anyway, so guess what? There's this secret escape plan I got. Tie a sheet to the bed, toss the end out the window, climb down and take off like a shot. Maybe though, not tonight. I ain't slept and my leg still ain't right. But hey, Pulitzer, he's going down. And then Jack, I was thinking we might just go, like you were saying, where it's clean and green and pretty, with no buildings in your way, and you're riding palominos every day. Once that train makes, damn this place. I'll be fine. Good as new. There's one thing I need you to do. On the rooftop, you said that a family looks out for each other. So you tell all the fellas from me to protect one another. The end. Friend, your best friend, your brother, Crutchy.
You in there, pipe down!
I owe you for that first backdrop, plus this one, and a little something extra, just because I'm going to miss you so.
Miss Meadow.
Jack.
You're a gem.
Now just tell me you're going somewhere and you're not just running away.
Does it matter?
Well, when you go somewhere and it turns out not to be the right place, you can always go somewhere else, but if you're running away, nowhere's ever going to be the right place.
Hey. How about letting a pal know you're alive?
Why don't I leave you with your friend?
Where'd you go? We couldn't find you. Ever think I didn't want to be found? Is that a real place? Is that Santa Fe? You see the paper? We're front page news, above the fold. Yes, above the fold.
Good for you.
Everyone wants to meet the famous Jack Kelly. Even Spot Collins sent a kid just to say, next event you can count on Brooklyn.
We got stomped to the ground.
Yeah, they got us this time, I'll grant you that. But we took round one, and with press like this, our fight is far from over.
Every newsie who could walk showed up this morning like the strike never happened.
And I was there with them. If I don't sell papers, my folks don't eat.
Save your breath, I get it, it's hopeless.
But then I saw this look on Weasel's face. He was actually nervous. And I realized, this isn't over. We got them worried, really worried, and I walked away. Lots of other kids did too, and that is what you call a beginning.
There he is, just like I said.
For crying out loud, where's a fella gotta go to get away from you people?
You can't escape us, pal, we're inevitable.
So, What's the story? Will Meta let us have the theater?
Pipe down, I didn't ask him yet.
What's the holdup? I gotta let my girl know we've got a date.
Oh, your girl?
You heard me. I've been swatting skirts away all morning. Fame is one intoxicating potion. And this here girl, Sally, she's a plum.
What is, you wrote a great story.
You look like hell.
Hey, Jack, what's this?
It's Santa Fe.
I gotta tell you, Jack, this go west young man routine is getting tired. Even Horace Greeley moved back to New York.
Yes, he did. And then he died.
Hey, ain't reporters supposed to be nonpartisan?
Ask a reporter. Pulitzer's had me blacklisted from every news desk in town.
Can we table the palaver and get back to business? Will Meta let us have the theater?
It's what I've been trying to tell you. We want to hold a rally. Citywide meeting where every newsie gets a say and a vote, and we do it after working hours so nobody loses a day's pay. Smart?
He's smart enough to get you committed to a padded room.
The guy who paints places he's never seen is calling us crazy.
Oh, you want to see a place I've seen? How about this? Newsy Square, thanks to my big mouth, filled to overflowing with failure. Kids hurt? Others arrested?
Lighten up. No one died.
Is that what you're aiming for? Go ahead, call me a quitter, call me a coward. Ain't no way I'm putting them kids back in danger.
We're doing something that has never been done before. How could that not be dangerous?
Speck sprung me a letter from Crutchy at the refuge. I tried to go see him. I climbed the fire escape, but they busted him up so bad he couldn't even get to the window. What if he don't make it, huh? You on the shoulder of that for a tenth of a penny of pay?
It's not about the pennies. You said it yourself, my family wouldn't be in this mess if my father had a union. This is a fight we have to win.
If I want a sermon, I'd go to church.
Well, tell me how quitting does Crutchy any good. Exactly. So here's how it goes. Once we win, and we will be winning, make no mistake.
We'll be what?
We're already winning.
Right.
And we'll tell them straight out. They let Crutchy go off. They keep getting pounded.
Dave, what the hell? Did they bust up your brains or something? As I recall, Dave, we all got our asses kicked. They won
the battle.
Come on.
Jackie, think about it. We got them surrounded.
Here's what I think. Joe's a jerk. He's a rattlesnake.
You're right. And you know why your snake starts to rattle.
Oh, why?
Because he's scared.
Come on.
Go and look it up, the poor guy's head is spinning. My buddy sent for the goons, an entire army, dozens of goons, plus the cops, and
you know you may be right,
thank you God,
if he wasn't afraid.
Exactly,
he knows we're winning. Get those kids to see we're circling victory, and watch what happens. We're doing something no one's even tried, and yes, we're terrified, but watch what happens.
You can't undo the past,
so just move on and stay on track. Cause Humpty Dumpty is about to crack.
We've got faith,
we've got the plan,
we've got Jack,
so just watch what happens.
How can you have so much sympathy for the trolley workers and yet have none for the newsies?
Because the trolley workers are striking for a fair contract. The newsies are striking against me.
I'd save you this embarrassment if I could, but the burlesque house is private property.
He can't order a raid without legal cause.
Mr. Mayor, would the fact that this rally is being organized by an escaped convict be enough to shut it down?
An escaped convict?
A fugitive from one of your own institutions. A convicted thief at large wreaking mischief on our law-abiding community. Mr. Snyder, which one is he?
That one there, Jack Kelly.
And how do you know this boy?
His is not a pleasant story. He was first sentenced to my refuge for loitering and vagrancy, though his blatant disregard for authority has made him a frequent visitor.
You called him a thief and an escaped convict.
Last, after his release, I caught him myself red-handed, trafficking stolen food and clothing. He was sentenced to 6 months, though the willful ruffian escaped.
So, you'd be doing the city a service by removing this criminal from our streets.
If that is the case, we can take him quietly.
What good does quiet do me? I want a public example made of him.
Mr. Pulitzer, the boy, Jack Kelly, is here.
Here?
Just outside. He's asked to speak with you.
Well, ask and ye shall be received. Mr. Snyder, if you please, sit.
Mr. Jack Kelly.
Morning, gents.
Now, which Jack Kelly is this? The charismatic union organizer or the petty thief and escaped convict?
Which one gives us more in common?
Impudence is in bad taste when crawling for mercy.
Crawling? Oh, that's a laugh. No, I just came with a little invite. Seems a few hundred of your employees are rallying to discuss recent disagreements. I thought it only fair to invite you to state your case straight to the fellas. So what do you say, Joe? When I should save you a spot on the ballot?
You are a shameless and disrespectful a creature, as I've been told. Do you know what I was doing at your age, boy? I was fighting in a war.
Yeah? How'd that turn out for you?
Taught me a lesson that shaped my life. You don't win wars on the battlefield. It's the headline that crowns the victor.
I'll keep that in mind when New York City wakes up to front page photos of our rally.
Oh, rally till the cows come home, but not a paper in town will print a word. And if it's not in the paper, it never happened.
Yeah, you may run this city, but there are some of us that can't be bullied, even some reporters.
Like that young lady that made you yesterday's news. Talented girl, and quite beautiful, don't you think?
I'll tell her you said so.
No need. She can hear for herself. Can't you, sweetheart? I trust you know my daughter, Catherine. Yes, my daughter. Now I'm sure you're asking why the gnome de plume and why doesn't my daughter work for me? All good questions. I offered Catherine a life of wealth and leisure, but instead she wanted to pursue a career. And she was showing some promise until this recent lapse. But you're all done with that now, aren't you, sweetheart?
Jack.
No, no, don't bother the boy with your troubles. Darling, Mr. Kelly has a plate full of his own. Wouldn't you say so, Mr. Snyder?
Hello, Jack.
Oh, does anyone else feel a noose tightening? Now, allow me to offer an alternate scenario. You will attend this rally and speak against this hopeless strike, and I will see your criminal record expunged and your pockets filled with enough cash to take you on a first-class train compartment from New York to New Mexico and beyond. You did say he wanted to travel west, didn't you?
There ain't a person in this room who don't know you stink.
And if they know me, they know I don't care. Mark my words, boy. Defy me, and I will have you and all your friends locked away in the refuge. I know you're Mr. Tough Guy. But it's not right to condemn a crippled boy to conditions like that. Oh, and what about your friend?
Davy.
Davy and his baby brother ripped from their loved ones and tossed to the rats? Will they ever be able to thank you enough? Time's running out, kid. So what do you say? Cowboy or convict, I win either way. Your abject surrender was always the bottom line. Gentlemen, escort our friend to the cellar so he may reflect in solitude. Too bad you'd no job, Jack, but you did resign. Too bad you'd no family, but you can't have mine. Be glad you're alive, boy. I say that's the bottom line.
Like the Pied Piper, you knew what to play.
Till those boys all believed you were right.
Lucky for them, all but one got away.
They may not be so lucky tonight.
Come on. We've been given discretion to handle you as we see fit. So behave.
Ah, but just in case, I've been polishing my favorite brass knuckles.
You can sleep right here on this old printing press. Now that there is fun.
Newsies need our help today.
Newsies need our help today.
Brooklyn's on the way.
Tell them Brooklyn's on the way.
We're from Brooklyn. We are
Newsies.
We are Brooklyn
Newsies. Just got word that our body's deserted. Faced the total disaster for certain. That's our cue point to find the ghost of it. They can hide in the gallery's of it. Have no fear. Brooklyn's here.
We'll get to rhythm
with the payback. We're the voice of the future's of pride. Run back hard in the Navy Yard, yeah. Sights ain't far, but the shore is exciting. Loud and clear, Brooklyn's here.
Borrower gave me boy, friendliest place on earth. Pays us a vision, sees what we mean, and when you do,
we'll pick you halfway.
Let's hear it for Spot Tomlin in Brooklyn.
Newsies United!
Yeah! Hey, let's see what Pulitzer's got to say to us now.
Hey, Davey, where's Jack?
Sorry, kid. No sign of him yet. It's like you're doing.
Yeah.
Jack!
Newsies of New York! Look at what we've done. We've got Newsies from every paper and every neighborhood here tonight. Tonight, you're making history. Tonight, we declare that we're just as much a part of the newspaper as any reporter or editor.
Yeah, that's right.
We are done being treated like kids. From now on, they'll treat us as equals.
You want to be talked to like an adult, then start acting like one. Don't just run your mouth, make some sense.
And here's Jack.
All right. So Pulitzer raised the price of papes without so much as a word to us. And that was a lousy thing to do.
Yeah, very lousy.
And so we got mad, and we let him know we ain't gonna be pushed around. So we go on strike. Then what happens? Pulitzer lowers his prices so we go back to work. Then a few weeks later, he hikes them right back up again, and don't think he won't. So what do we do then, huh? And what do we do if he decides to raise his prices again after that? Fellas, we gotta be realistic. If we don't work, we don't get paid. How many days can you go without making money, huh? However long, believe me, Pulitzer can go longer.
What? What are you talking about?
What? I have spoken to Mr. Pulitzer myself, and he has given me his word. If we disband the union, he will even put it in writing. Look, I say we take the deal. Go back to work, knowing our price is secure. All we gotta do is just vote no on this strike.
How about we vote you getting out of here?
How'd you get up here?
Specs showed me.
He said you could go through my stuff?
I saw them sticking out of there. I didn't know what they were. These drawings.
These are drawings of the refuge, aren't they? Is this really what it's like in there? Three boys to a bed, rats everywhere, and vermin?
Yeah, a little different from where you were raised, huh?
Snyder told my father you were arrested stealing food and clothing. This is why, isn't it? You stole to feed those boys. I don't understand. If you're willing to go to jail for those boys, how could you turn your back on them now?
Oh, I don't think you're anyone to talk about turning on folks.
I never turned on you or anyone else.
No, no, you just double-crossed us to your father. Your father?
My father has eyes on every corner of this city. He doesn't need me spying for him. And I never lied. I didn't tell you everything.
Well, if you weren't a girl, you'd be trying to talk with a fist in your mouth.
I said I worked for the Sun, and I did. I told you my professional name was Plumber, and it is. You never asked my real one.
I wouldn't think I had to, unless I knew I was dealing with a backstabber.
Oh, and if I were a boy, you'd be looking at me through one swollen eye!
Yeah, don't let that stop you. Go ahead. Give me your best shot.
I need to know you didn't cave for the money.
No. No, I spoke the truth. Look, you win a fight when you got the other fella down eating pavement. You heard your father. No matter how many days we strike, he ain't giving up. I don't know what else we can do.
But I do.
Come on.
Oh, really, Jack? Really? Only you can have a good idea? Or is it because I'm a girl?
Whoa, I didn't say nothing.
This would be a really good time for you to shut up. Being boss doesn't mean you have all the answers. Just the brains to recognize the right one when you hear it.
I'm listening.
Good for you! The strike was your idea, the rally was Davy's, and now my plan will take us to the finish line. Deal with it.
The Children's Crusade?
For the sake of all the kids in every sweatshop, factory, and slaughterhouse in New York, I beg you, join us. With those words, the strike stopped being just about the Newsies. You challenged our entire generation to stand up and demand a place at the table.
The Children's Crusade.
Think, Jack, if we publish this, my words, with one of your drawings, and if every worker under the age of 21 read it and stayed home from work, or better yet, came to Newsies Square, a general citywide strike. Even my father couldn't ignore that.
Problem. We got no way to print it.
Come on, there's got to be one printing press he doesn't control. What?
I know where there's a print press no one would ever think we'd use.
Well, then why are we still standing
here?
Oh,
wait, stop. What's this about for you? I don't mean the Children's Crusade. What's this about? I mean, am I kidding myself, or is there something?
Of course there is.
Well, don't just say it like it happens every day.
Oh, Jack, I...
No, I'm not an idiot, okay? I know girls like you don't wind up with guys like me. I don't want you promising nothing you just gotta take back later. Standing here tonight, looking at you, I'm scared tomorrow's gonna come and change everything. If there was some way I could grab a hold of something to make time stop, just so I could keep on looking at you.
You snuck up on me, Jack Kelly. I never even saw it coming.
For sure?
For sure. Till the moment I found you, I thought I knew what love was. Now I'm learning what is true, that love will do what it does. The world finds ways to sting you, and then one day decides to bring you something to believe in, for even a night may be forever, but that's all right, that's all right. And if you're gone tomorrow, what was ours still will be. I have something to believe in, now that I know you believe in me.
was never meant to meet. And then we meet, who knows why? One more stranger on the street, just someone sweet passing by. An angel come to save me, who didn't even know she gave me something to believe in for even a day. One day, maybe forever, but that's okay, that's okay. And if I'm gone tomorrow, what was ours still will be. I got something to believe in, now that I know you believed in me. What I believe in, look into my eyes and see. If things were different.
If you weren't going to Santa Fe.
Yeah, and if you weren't an heiress. If your father wasn't after my head.
You're not really scared of my father.
But I am pretty scared of you.
Don't be!
And if I'm gone tomorrow,
what was ours still will be.
I have something to believe in, now that I know you believe in me. Entire building. Someone been picking Daddy's pockets?
The janitor has been working here since he was 8 years old and hasn't had a raise in over 20 years. He's with us 100%.
You bring the fellas to keep us covered?
We could hold a hoe down in here and no one would be the wiser.
Good job.
Hey, Jack. It's good to have you back again.
Shut up.
Here she is, boys. Just think, while my father snores blissfully in his bed, we will be using his very own printing press to bring him down.
Remind me to stay on your good side.
Hey, is this what they print the papers on?
Yeah, I could see why they tossed this old girl down the cellar, but I think she'll do the job.
Jack, this is Darcy. He knows just about everything there is to know about printing.
Oh, sorry. You work for one of the papers?
Oh, my father owns the Trib.
Whoa.
And this is Bill. He'll be typesetting the article for us.
Oh, Bill. So I suppose you're the son of William Randolph Hearst.
And proud to be part of your revolution.
Ain't that something?
In the words of the little one, can we table the palaver and get back to business?
A little grease and she'll be as good as gold.
All right. Here's how it's gonna work. As we print the papes, Race, you let the fellas in, and we'll spread them to every working kid in New York. After that,
it's up to them. There's change coming once and for all. You makes the front page, and man uses major news. Tomorrow they'll see what we are, and sure as a star, we ain't come this far to lose.
Here they come!
But this is a story we needed to write as we get out of sight a little more. In a few hours by dawn's early light, we'll be ready to fight us some more. This time we're in it to stay. Talk about seizing the day.
Write it in ink or in blood, it's the same either way. They're gonna damn well pay.
See him and Paul, it's a snug in his bed. He don't care if we're dead or alive. His satin pillows are under his head. On his bed, he broke a bread to survive. Joe, you can stop counting sheep. We're gonna sing yet asleep. Now while you snooze, we'll be light in a fuse with a promise we're taking to keep.
Yeah! Once and for all, if they don't mind, the manners will bleed up.
Bleed up!
Once and for all, we won't carry no banner that's
all about freedom. Finally raising the stakes. This time whatever it takes. This time the Union awakes. Once and for all.
In the words of Union leader Jack Kelly,
yeah,
we will work with you. We will even work for you, but we will be paid and treated as valuable members of your organizations. Riveting stuff, huh?
Hey, get going. We've got a very important man to see.
Keep your fingers crossed.
For us, too. Got this.
This is for kids shining shoes on the street with no shoes on their feet every day. This is for guys sweating blood in their shops while the bosses and cops look away. I'm seeing kids standing tall, glaring and raring to brawl. Armies of guys who are sick of the lies, getting ready to rise to the call. Once and for all, there'll be blood on the wall if they doubt. They think they're running this town, but this town will shut down without us. 10,000 kids in the square,
10,000 kids in the square,
10,000 fists in the air,
10,000 fists.
Once and for all. Once and for all.
Yes, he's call you back. That is not kind of like it. He'll call you back.
Silence those phones!
The city is in turmoil. No one is working at... is working anywhere. Anyone's blaming you.
They're all calling. The mayor, the publishers, the manufacturers. And what language?
You can't just barge in. You're behind this? We had a deal.
Yeah, and it came with a money-back guarantee. Hey, and thanks for your lessons on the power of the press.
Did you read this, boss? These kids put out a pretty good paper. It's very convincing. No doubt written by my daughter.
Yeah, I'd sign her before someone else grabs her up.
I demand to know who defied my ban on printing strike material.
Oh, we're your loyal employees. We would never take our business elsewhere.
It's the old printing press in the cellar.
I offered you the deal of a lifetime. Anyone who does not act in their own self-interest is a fool!
Well, what's that make you? All of this happened because you wanted to print more papes, and now your circulation is down 70%. Why didn't you just come talk to us? Oh,
guys like Joe don't talk to nothings like us. But a very wise reporter told me a real boss don't need the answers, just the smarts to snatch up the right one when he hears it.
Now is the time to seize the day. Stare down the odds and seize the day. Minute by minute, that's how you win it. We will find our way. But let us seize the day.
Have a look out there, Mr. Pulitzer. In case you ain't figured it out, we've got you surrounded.
New York City is closed for business. Paralyzed. You can't get a paper or a shoe shine. You can't send a message or ride an elevator across the Brooklyn Bridge. You can't even leave your own building. So what's your next move?
Mr. Pulitzer, the mayor's here along with your daughter. And you're not gonna believe who else.
Good morning, Mr. Pulitzer. I think you know the governor.
Governor Roosevelt. Joseph, Joseph, Joseph. What have you done now?
I'm certain when you hear my explanation.
Thanks to Miss Meta Larkin bringing your daughter to my office, I already have a thorough grasp of the situation. Graphic illustrations included. Bully is the expression I usually employ to show approval. But in your case, I just mean bully. Is this the boy of whom you spoke? How are you, son? I'm told we once shared a carriage ride.
The pleasure's mine, Mr. Governor.
Well, Joe, don't just stand there letting those children sing endlessly. Tell them the good news.
What good news?
That you've come to your senses and have lowered your prices. Unless, of course, you wish to invite a full state Senate investigation into your employment practices.
You wouldn't.
After the pressure you wielded to keep me from office? I do it with a smile. Come along, Joseph. There's only one thing worse than a hard heart, and that's a soft head. And think of the happiness you'll bring to those children. He doesn't do happiness, does he?
Mr. Kelly, if I may speak to you alone.
Keep your eyes on the stars and keep your feet on the ground. You can do this.
I cannot put the price back where it was. I'm sorry, I can't. There are other considerations.
Yo, I get it, okay? You gotta save face in front of all these folks. I'm young, I ain't stupid.
Thank you for understanding.
But I got constituents with a legitimate gripe.
What if I reduce the raise by half? And get the other papers to do the same. It's a compromise we can all live with.
Okay. But you eat our losses. From now on, any papes we can't sell, you buy back full price.
No, that has never been on the table. What's to stop the newsies from buying hundreds of papers they can't sell? My costs will explode.
No newsie is going to break his back hauling around papes he can't sell. But if he could take a few more with no risk, he might sell those and your circulation would begin to grow. It's a compromise we can all live with.
That's not a bad head you've got on your shoulders.
Deal?
That's disgusting.
That's just the price of doing business.
We paid our dues,
And the things we do today will be tomorrow's news. And the die is cast, and the torch is passed, and the war will rise. Oh. Banks will grow and grow and grow and grow and grow and grow. And...
Newsies of New York City. We won!
Oh, my God! What?
Oh, and now, I'd like to introduce my own personal pal, Governor Theodore Roosevelt.
Each generation must, at the height of its power, step aside and invite the young to share the day. You have laid claim to our world, and I believe that the future in your hands will be bright and prosperous. And your drawing, son, have brought another matter to bear. Officers, if you please.
Officers, wait, whoa.
Hey, Jack, look here, it's Crutchy. Hey.
Hiya, fellas, you missed me.
Yes,
what I got you is a little gift straight from the refuge. Bring him in, fellas.
So tough now, is he?
Jack, with your drawings, you have made an eloquent argument for shutting down the refuge. Be assured that Mr. Snyder's offenses will be fully investigated. Officers, take him away.
Oh, Your Highness! Your Highness? Please.
May I do the honors?
Oh, you've got to be kidding!
And you'll be laughing all the way to the pen, little man.
Thanks, Mr. Governor.
I can't help thinking, if your drawings could convince the governor to close down the refuge, what might a daily political cartoon do to expose the dealings of our government back rooms? What do you say, Teddy? Here to have this young man's artistry shine a lantern behind your closed doors?
Hey, don't sweat it, Gov. Yeah, with the strike settled, I ought to be hitting the road.
Jack, where are you going?
Don't you ever get tired of singing the same old tune? What Santa Fe got that New York ain't? Tarantulas?
Better yet, what's New York got that Santa Fe ain't?
New York's got us, and we're family.
Ahem. Didn't I hear someone say the strike was settled?
Yeah, papes for the newsies. Line up, boys.
These papes ain't gonna sell themselves.
Well, come along, Governor, and let's see that vaccine I've been hearing so much about.
Well, don't just stand there. You've got a union to run. Besides, didn't someone just offer you a pretty exciting job?
Oh, what, me? Work for your father?
You already work for my father.
Oh, yeah.
And you've got one more ace up your sleeve.
Yeah, what would that be?
Me. Wherever you go, I'm there, right by your side.
For sure?
For sure.
Don't take much to be a dreamer. All you do is close your eyes. But some made-up world is all you'll ever see. Now my eyes is finally open, and my dreams, they's average-sized. But they don't much matter if you ain't with me.
Guys!
Well, Jack, you in or you out? Okay, I'm going.
Yeah.
I'm on.
Hey! We're always out there carrying the benefits of man. We're always out there stroking every sucker that we can. Here's a headline: Newsies on a mission, kill the competition, sell the next edition. We'll be out there.